all knew her by her will to make it whatever she put her mind to. Late night hours up the hill, serving coffee to strangers, talking about revenue. Welcome back, y'all. We are continuing the saga of the wiring today. Plan on getting the rest of the wire for the living room ran. Maybe getting the outdoor outlets installed. The switches, the outlets, finished up in the living room. And possibly moving on to the bathroom today. I'll actually give you a sneak peek here in a little bit of the bathroom floor, which is finally done. Grout is finished in there. And over here we have the Duroc. That is for the wood stove hearth. It's gonna go right here where you're sitting at the moment. And the boards over there on the wall.
I know, I said no drywall in this house.
Now, this is not drywall. This is tough rock. This is a mold resistant tough rock, and it is for the laundry room in the bottom half of the bathroom. And that is just to help with moisture and mold. So the laundry room will get that tough rock in there, and the bathroom will get it on the lower half of it, just to help prevent mold and moisture issues. Because this right here is my wood. It is starting to acclimate to the temperatures and humidity in the cabin. And it is ready to sit here for a little while. And then I will plane it, edge it, and we'll get it up on the walls eventually. It won't be too awful long. About a month or so before I can start working with this wood here. So, anyway, let's get to it. We've got a lot of wiring to do. I'm gonna throw in some video from yesterday when I started running this wire in the living room. And then we'll jump into today, finishing this wiring up. All right, let's go.
Thank you.
house wires. Don't play nice.
They don't play nice at all. They're stubborn. Because they're a lot thicker. Thicker than the 14s. And just keep screwing them in till you get them in there and put the plate on, and that outlet's done. And then we'll move on to the next one.
Thank you.
just got a text from Gary, who is with Crazy Cluckers Farm, and he gave me the information on how to hook up this wire here. So what I'm doing here is I have power coming from the sub panel, power going to this light here, which is my outdoor porch light. But I also need power, not the switch to work it. This switch will only work this outdoor light, but I need power to continue on from this box and go into the living room to the switches in there for the outdoor light in there, the chandelier, and the light sconces near the fireplace. So, wood stove, not fireplace. So, to get power from here without this switch working that power, and with this switch working that power, that's what I need. So the switch works this light, but the switch does not work the power in there. So he sent me a little graphic here of how to do that. I sent him a picture, and I showed him what I needed. And this is what he sent back. So this is how I'm going to hook this up. So we're going to use pigtails. What we're going to do, little pieces of extra wire for the hot and for the neutral. The red will just be floating around back there. The copper will just be hooked into here. So I'll twist the copper wire. This is the one coming from the living room. So I'll put the copper wire from here and twist it into that. That just gives it a ground. The white wire, which is my neutral, it looks like that one is going to just be hooked into these neutrals here. Not a big deal. Pretty simple. And then the black wire is the kicker. The black wire will need to be adjusted. So we have the black, which is our hot wire, coming in from the panel right here. And now that I've got this out of here, I can clean this box out. this is all dead. This is not a live wire. This is turned off the panel. So this black one here, this one right here coming in from the sub panel, it will be taken off of this switch. It will be wire nutted to the black one off of this one from the living room. And then I'll have an extra piece of wire that'll also be a wire nutted into that group. Then that will come to this switch. That way we'll have power working this switch to the outdoor light, but we'll also have power running from this area over and out to the living room switches. So let's get to working on that. I wasn't sure how to do it, but he taught me. This, you could do this with the wire nut. We're gonna put a wire nut on there. Probably gonna need a bigger one. Oh no, that's perfect. Okay, so we're using the yellow wire nut for three 12 tube wires. Here we go. All right. Now, so now we have power coming from the sub panel into this, and from this onto the living room, and from this onto this switch. So we're good. Make us a hook. Oh, we might need to strip that a little bit more. That's a little, ain't much showing there. We need that stripped. Because we need to make a hook. We can't make a hook if you don't got enough wire showing. There we go. Now, we can make a hook. Perfect little hook. Right, so that hook is going to go onto this one. So we'll flip it over because we want to make sure that it goes the right direction. We'll hook that onto the switch. Come on, baby, get on that switch. Sometimes they're kind of a bear to get on the switches. Go. Now we got it. So it's on there now. It's going the right direction, which is the same direction. The hook goes the same direction as you're screwing this in. Alright, here we go. So now we have power going to the living room. Now, let's deal with these neutral wires here. One. We got one that's going from the light switch, we got one that's going from the main power, and we got one that's going to the living room power. I want them all to be about the same size. So let me grab another wire nut, get another yellow one, and we'll hook this together. Of a pain because this door wants to open every time I bang on this wall. The sub panel into this outlet box. We have power to the switch. which goes to what it will be the outdoor light for the porch off of the laundry room. We also have power coming out of this, going up, over, and into the living room. This white wire runs all the way through here and to here. And I'm in the process of running it up the wall. That's the next step. I've got to drill a hole up there.
And we got to go through all five of those studs.
Those two, all five of those studs, back down. And to this switch right here. So right there, yeah, that's a good place for it. I like that. Play a little bit. Thank goodness for the light on this thing. If you can see that or not, hopefully I can adjust the camera enough for you to see that. There's the outlet box right there. And that is the switch, and that switch is a triple switch, not a three-way switch, a triple switch. So it's got three little paddles on it that work three different lights. The first one, which I just wired up right here, is the outdoor light, the porch light. The second one will be the indoor light, the chandelier in the living room. And the third one will run over to the fireplace area, wood stove area, and there'll be a sconce on either side of the fireplace. So now we have an outdoor light. We have a switch plugged, wired up for that outdoor light. We've got main power into the switch. It's turned off right now, breaker's off. But there is power into the switch. And so now let's run the wire over to where the chandelier's gonna go. I can't do the chandelier yet. It's gonna take the big, big ladder and somebody a whole lot less scared of heights than me to put that chandelier up there. But I can get the wiring ran across the top wall and ready to run it up there. We'll do that. I have all the wiring in the living room for the power done. Just got one more set of outlets to put the actual outlet on. I have all of the lighting wire circuit ran from the sub panel to the laundry room lights for the outdoor light there. Coming out in here, coming through all of my walls in here and into the switch by the door. Also have from that switch to the outdoor light and have the outdoor light put up in the front. And the power ran over and ready to go to the chandelier eventually. Right now, woo! And off camera, I worked on putting up the little chandelier in the bathroom. It's really dark in there, so you wouldn't have been able to really see anyway. But got that all put together and up, for the most part, up. I have to make some adjustments to it on the height of it. It's way too low right now, so I need to make it go up higher. And other than that, the bathroom is about ready because the vent fan is hooked up, the vanity light wiring is done, and just have to find me a vanity light that I like. The one that was given to me is missing integral pieces that I need to make it work, and it would cost more to find those integral pieces and replace them than it would be to just buy another one. So I'm on the lookout for a vanity light that I like that will match good with my little chandelier and my rustic but bougie pretty theme in the bathroom. So that's what's been going on, y'all. Thank you for joining me for another video, and I hope you have a wonderful week, wonderful weekend, and God bless. Love ya.